Any time is a great time to get into astronomy, but I believe 2024 is the perfect time, and I'm going to tell you 5 ways you can get into the hobby for free. The 5th method is my favorite, and I believe that you and I can work together to build something that will help others in the future. This video may be helpful for those of you who are already in the hobby because you may learn about a resource or two that you've never known about. The first item is a naked eye phenomena. The first thing that comes to mind for a lot of people when they hear astronomy is telescope. Although a telescope can help, it's not necessary for many astronomical events. In this video, I talked about 10 astronomical events that you can observe without a telescope. Well, 9.5 because one involved Neptune. Events such as planetary and lunar conjunctions, meteor showers, sometimes comets, and solar and lunar eclipses are all visible to the naked eye. You can also use sites like darkskyfinder.com and lightpollutionmap.info and travel to darker areas and observe the Milky Way galaxy and dimmer meteor showers. And we're hoping a couple comets in 2024 will light up the night sky. And on April 8, 2024, North America will witness a total solar eclipse. If you're already in the path of totality, awesome. But if you're not and you have the ability to, consider traveling to the path of totality because you may not get another chance for 21 years. Hundreds of millions of people around the continent will get to enjoy at least a partial solar eclipse, but you need solar eclipse glasses to enjoy that. And you can potentially get yourself one for free through a program called the Solar Eclipse Activities for Libraries, or SEAL for short, all around the United States. You can read more about it at starnetlibraries.org, or you can use the map on scigames.org/eclipses/map to find a library near you that carries these glasses. Contact them to learn about their distribution plans. And on top of that, I plan on giving away about another 100 solar eclipse glasses like I did during the October annular eclipse, so stay tuned for that for more information in February. Second way to get into the hobby is using free mobile apps. Technology is amazing, and if you have access to a smartphone or a tablet or a phablet, then you can use one of these free mobile apps to learn the night sky. If you ever looked up in the sky and wondered what the heck is that bright light up there, well, one of these apps can tell you that, hey, it's Jupiter, or it's Sirius, or it's an asteroid heading our way. Some apps use AR, or augmented reality, so you can overlay the app directly onto the sky. Accuracy may be a bit off, but you can use these apps to learn about the brightest stars in the sky, planets that are visible to the naked eye, where the moon will pop out of in the sky, constellations, and more. Some of my favorite apps include Starwalk 2, which comes with AR capabilities and is great for learning the constellations and about the sky. Another favorite app of mine is called Skyview. Both free and paid versions come with AR capabilities. It's great for planets, the sun, the moon, meteor showers, constellations, and eclipse planning. Delirium Mobile is the third app I'll mention. It's very powerful and accurate in showing you where something is in the sky and when you can see it. And the desktop version is even better, and it's all free. I frequently use Delirium to enhance my videos here on YouTube, as well as plan my astronomy and astrophotography sessions. There are plenty of other apps that you can use, both paid and free, to learn about astronomy and the night sky. If there's any interest, I'll create a dedicated video talking about more of the astronomy apps that I use for this hobby. The next item on the list is astronomy clubs. Most astronomy clubs have a fee for you to join, but they will allow you to visit them for free. Sky and Telescope has a database of astronomy clubs on their website from 6 of the 7 continents, and that means that someone in Antarctica needs to open an astronomy club soon. Use the database on skyandtelescope.com, find an astronomy club near you, reach out to them and ask when you can visit, and go visit them. See what kind of telescopes the club uses, what kind of telescopes their members use, how they engage in astronomy and astrophotography, and just network. You'll be surprised just how much you can learn just by talking to people. And if there's one thing I can guarantee about astronomers, is that we love talking about astronomy for hours, for free. Many astronomy clubs are also near darker areas, so you have the opportunity to see things like the Milky Way galaxy or dimmer meteor showers. And astronomy clubs near or in bright cities will generally have larger focal length telescopes that you can use to get a closer look at the moon, the sun, or planets. Fourth way to get into the hobby for free is to attend public observing events. This one is near and dear to me because the public astronomy event at a local community college when I was in high school reignited my love for this hobby. I saw surface details of Mars and the rings of Saturn through their large telescope, and I was instantly hooked. And I knew that I needed my own telescope, and that was about 20 years ago now. So how do you find these public astronomy events? Well, Google is your friend. If there's a college or university near you, especially if they have an astronomy program, Google their name plus observatory and look at their site. Sometimes they'll have information on their websites containing information on public astronomy nights, such as this one at Harvard or this one at Boston University, or this one at Dartmouth, or this one at Texas A&M University at Kingsville. If you know that they have an observatory but no information on public astronomy nights, reach out to them and ask them if they run one. And if they don't, maybe this will give them an idea that maybe they need to because the community is interested. Aside from those public events, you can also look at your local astronomy club and see if they run star parties. My astronomy club, the Amateur Telescope Makers of Boston, occasionally runs star parties for schools and libraries around the Eastern Massachusetts area. So you can also look up your local libraries and schools and see if they do any kind of astronomy events that you as a community member could attend. Star parties are almost a guarantee of having a telescope on the field that you can use to look through. Individuals can also run star parties. For example, David Fuller from Eyes on the Sky, one of the nicest people I've ever interacted with, will occasionally host meetups in his backyard where you can go and look at the night sky. I very heavily recommend his channel. Link in the description below. 2023 was just one of 2 years since 2012 that I was not able to host a star party, but normally I try to host between 1 and 5 every year, and I'm hoping that I can do that in 2024. So follow me and other astronomers on social media for announcements on when we host star parties. Number 5, Library of Things. My first real job was at a library, and a library of things wasn't a thing back then. And for those of you who are unaware of what a library of things is, as the name suggests, it's just a way for the library to let you borrow things other than books, like telescopes and binoculars that you can use for astronomy for free. If you're in Massachusetts like I am, then you're in luck because a bunch of libraries in the state carry telescopes that you can borrow. This here is part of the Minuteman Library Network, and they have a bunch of Orion Star Blasts through their network. The Orion Star Blast is a tabletop Dobsonian, and it's an amazing telescope for beginners. And borrowing it from the library is a really great way of trying it out and see if this hobby is for you, without ever having to spend a dime. If you do borrow telescopes, try and not damage them like these two in the Brookline branch here. Other libraries around the world may offer something similar, like this library in Levittown, New York. Here you can get a refractor and a set of binoculars to play with. If you're not sure if your local library has a library of things, reach out to them and ask them if they don't have any information online. And if they don't have one, maybe suggest a library of things. And if they do have a library of things but no telescope, maybe suggest that they get a telescope that people can borrow. And I want to build a list or a database of telescopes that you can get through libraries around the world. Google can only go so far, but I'm hoping that you can help me out. If you know that your library has a library of things, and if they have a telescope, let me know in the comments below. I'd love to add that to my database. I plan on publishing that database online for everyone to use. In the meantime, you can find links to the Levittown Public Library and the Minuteman Library Network in the description below. I hope this video was somewhat informative, whether you're just trying to get into the hobby or you've already been in this hobby for a while. If you learned something new today and you're not already subscribed, consider subscribing and join me on our next astronomy adventure. In the meantime, check out this video here where I share my top 10 astronomical events that you can see in 2024 without a telescope. Clear skies.